from Hollywood, the National Broadcasting Company brings you transcribed The Martin and Lewis Show. Our guest tonight, Dorothy Kirsten, featuring Flo McMichael, Sheldon Leonard, Ben Alexander, Dick Stabile and his orchestra, and starring Dean Martin.
Night and day, you are the one.
And Jerry Lewis.
Night and day, you are the one. Only you beneath the moon and under the sun.
Beneath the moon and under the sun? What's the matter? Ain't you got a house?
Well, now we find Dean and Jerry in the new nightclub they're planning to open. They seem to have everything they need now except performers, money, and customers.
Jerry, I'm awful worried about our club.
Maybe the club needs some good-looking women. That's what it needs.
Jerry, you're always thinking about women. You know what Kipling said? Women are just a rag, a bone, and a hank of hair.
Yeah, but they're put together so nicely. Dean, you know what I think we ought to have in our floor show is girls.
Yeah, girls are fun. I know, I read a lot.
That's what I'm trying to tell you, Dean. I've already taken care of the feminine department for our nightclub.
You mean you've hired a fan dancer?
No, an opera singer. Miss Dorothy Kirsten. And she'll be here any minute.
Dorothy Kirsten? But Jerry, she doesn't sing in nightclubs. Does she know that this is a nightclub?
Well, no. I thought it was sort of an indoor Hollywood bowl.
Ah, but Jerry is...
Hey, Dean, look who just came in.
Hello, boys. How's the nightclub coming?
Well, it's our cigarette girl, Tondaleo Hockenhaven.
Well, hello, Tondaleo. How are the cigarettes going?
Deanie, I don't want to be a cigarette girl. I just want to be near you.
You do?
Yeah. I can't stifle my emotion any longer. Oh, Deanie, will you bite the lobe of my ear just once?
What's that? I don't understand.
She doesn't understand. I gotta have a long talk with this boy.
I think I'll go now. I have an appointment.
Oh, don't go, Deanie. I came all the way over here to see you. Aren't you glad to see little Tondaleo? Well, aren't you? Well, Deanie boy, say something.
Hello, baby.
Oh, Deanie.
I'm leaving.
Oh, Jerry, please, don't.
Oh, Deanie, why can't we be alone? Why must your little boy always tag along? Oh, Deanie, hold me tight. Let me look in your big brown eyes. Or are they blue? Or are they gray?
They're chartreuse. Now, please, Tondaleo, we've got to get things organized a bit. You see, Miss Dorothy Kirsten is coming to sing in our club, and I don't...
Dorothy Kirsten? But why? Why spend all that money when you got me?
You mean you sing?
Do I sing? A little arpeggio, please. I'm forever blowing bravo. Pretty bubble in the air.
There, how is that? Tondaleo, darling, we have a message for you.
Yes, Tondaleo, darling, why don't you go to Arthur Murray?
But Arthur Murray's a dancing teacher. He just tell me where to put my feet.
I know that. Maybe he'll tell you to put one of your feet in your mouth. Goodbye. Gee, Dean, I think we ought to look for a new cigarette girl. Tondaleo is beginning to fall for you.
Oh, never mind. I'm worried about Dorothy Kirsten coming here. I'm telling you, Jerry, when she sees this joint, she'll quit. Besides, she isn't the kind of an act you want in a nightclub. She's too classy. We want something, well, a little more...
Speak no further, friend. Your troubles are over. It's me, your old friend, Sophie. I am now a theatrical agent, D. Lukes. I can get you any kind of act that you want. In fact, I've been lining all day up talent.
I've been lining all day up talent?
Yeah.
That's as bad as up the street, the soldiers are coming down.
Come on in, group. Come on.
What a cast. What a cast.
Now, hold on there, Soapy. We don't want to have...
Take it easy, friend. I represent nothing but high-class talent. Just get a load of this little lady here, Miss Fifi La Fifi. What a dancer. I tell you, the fellas go wild. She moves muscles she ain't got.
Tell you what, go ahead, Fifi. Dance for the gentleman. Hit it, boys.
Well, that's very nice, but...
She had one left over.
Look, Toby, that's not the kind of act we want in this place. We want refined act. That's why we hired the opera singer, Miss Dorothy Kirsten.
Now, please, boy, you are wounding little old Soapy.
Now, let's get down to business. Here is another great act for a nightclub. Here is Think a Drink Shapiro.
Think a Drink Shapiro.
Yes, that is I, Think a Drink Shapiro. Go ahead, think of a drink, and I'll pour it out of my magic cocktail shaker.
Okay. A martini.
A martini, righto. Here you are, a martini. Taste it.
Okay. Wait a minute, this is nothing but 7-Up.
I know, I haven't got a liquor license.
Oh, what a performer, huh? Well, what do you say, boys? Is it a deal?
No.
Please, Soapy, go away. Dr. Kirsten will be here any minute.
Yes,
and like...
Soapy, we don't want any characters like you hanging around. She might get the wrong impression of this place. And we want her to... Hey, what are you doing behind the bar? Put those bottles down.
But, Dean,
Jerry, you know you've never been behind a bar in your life.
I know, but, Dean, I'm experimenting. I'm making up a special kind of drink to serve our customers.
Oh, well, that's different. Special kind of drink can make this place famous. Well, what are you putting in this little drink of yours?
Well, first I put in a little Cuban rum. Then I put in a little West Indian rum. Then I put in a pinch of African rum. Then a little French rum. Then a little Brazilian rum. Then I take a little jigger of Mexican rum. I use 85 different kinds of rum in this drink.
85 different kinds of rum in one drink? Well, what's it called?
Gin Fizz. And now to clear the air, Dean Martin will sing Tootsie from the picture Jolson sings again and again and again and again and again. And ooh, is he making money?
Tootsie, goodbye. Tootsie, don't cry. The choo-choo train that takes me away from you, no words can tell how sad it makes me. Kiss me, Tootsie, and then do it over again. Watch for the mail, I'll never fail. If you don't get a letter, then you know I'm in jail. You're calling, Tootsie, don't cry. Tootsie, goodbye. Watch for the mail, I'll never fail. If you don't get a letter, then you know I'm in jail. You're calling, Tootsie, don't cry. Tootsie, goodbye.
Hey, that was very nice, Dean.
Well, thanks, Jerry.
Gee, I sure hope Dorothy Kirsten will show up here at the club. She's just what we need. Class. She'll bring us the carriage trade.
But, Jerry, a nightclub is no place for babies.
Dean, sometimes I think I need you like a hole in the head.
Jerry, you've got a hole in your head.
I wondered where the light was coming from when my mouth was closed.
You know, Jerry, I'm excited about meeting Miss Kirsten. If I can trade ideas about music with her, it'll do our team good.
If you can trade bodies with her, it'll do our team even more good.
Now, you don't understand, Jerry. You see, we musicians, we live in a world of our own where we speak only of cadenzas, arpeggios, fortissimos, and take fives.
I beg your pardon. You are Martin von Lewis, yeah?
Yeah.
I am Professor Rover von Bagel.
Your name is Rover?
Yeah. My parents wanted a dog. But you have written a letter to do Miss Dorothy Kirsten of the Metropolitan Opera.
Don't tell me you're Dorothy Kirsten. Dean, get a chair for the lady.
Dunkus, I'm not a lady.
Then you ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Gentlemen, I am here to inform you I will not permit Miss Kirsten to sing in a swing chime like this.
Oh, now, wait a minute. I don't mind the place, and you know I also sing a little bit.
Yeah, but such a little bit. Now, Miss Kirsten only appears in reputable opera houses. You see, her music is only by Tchaikovsky, Mussorgsky, and Verdi.
They must be beginning. Do you know any of those songwriters?
Yeah, now and then they come in for a free beer.
Tchaikovsky, Mussorgsky, and Verdi are dead.
And I don't want them coming in here anymore, though. Give the place a bad name.
Now, I will not permit Miss Kirsten to work here. You may as well get that through your cough.
Cough? What's that?
Cough? Oh, that's head.
Yeah, yeah, lungs, Mom. Ist das nicht ein Schnitzelbein?
Klar, das ist nicht das Schnitzelbein.
I do, China Schnitzelbein.
Wait a minute. You're being so impolite. The rest of us here don't understand French.
He don't understand music either. But he don't understand opera.
Opera? What's so tough about opera? I could be an opera singer.
Huh? You are opera singer? Well, you have to weigh 300 pounds. You only weigh 150. And half of that is Jerry Lewis.
Listen, Dean's a good singer. He's my partner, and I'll say that all the time like it was true.
You just don't know me. But for your information, I once sang the part of the devil in Carmen.
The devil is in the opera Faust.
He sings like the devil in any opera.
Von Bagel, you talk like a big man, but what do you know about music?
What do I know about music? Why, let me tell you, I was a child prodigy.
Jay, what's a child prodigy?
Well, that's a kid that prodges.
Oh, come on, let's can all the chatter. Is Miss Kirsten coming over or not?
Well, she will be here, but she will not sing. Ha-ha! Here is my liebchen now. Herr Martin, may I present Miss Dorothy Kirsten?
How do you do, Mr. Martin?
Hello, baby.
Miss Kirsten, I have told these people you will not sing in such a low-class club.
Herr von Bagel, I sing everywhere where people love music. La, 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 la.
Bravo! Say, with a little training, she could be another Vaughn Monroe. On second thought, who needs two Vaughn Monroes?
Oh, Jerry, I love music, Miss Kirsten. In fact, I've often dreamed of becoming an opera singer.
That's wonderful, Dean, but it's hard work. Most opera singers have to start at the bottom.
And for Dean, we'd have to dig a hole and start even deeper.
This fellow has a split personality, and we are getting the worst half.
Miss Kirsten, how about letting me sing some opera with you?
Perhaps you know Samson, Delilah?
Samson and Delilah. Sure, wonderful couple. Did they ever get married?
Yeah, they had a double wedding with Lum and Abner.
I'd sure like to sing with you, Dorothy.
Well, I'd love to, Dean. You know, all this summer I sang with Nelson Eddy.
Here she goes, from shortening bread to ravioli.
I'm sure that Dean and I could sing together. Besides Nelson, I've sung with Lawrence Tibbett, Lawrence Melchior, and now Frank Sinatra.
Well, how do you like singing with Sinatra?
Oh, he's just like Lawrence Melchior. condensed by Reader's Digest.
Well, what do you say we try a number?
All right, Dean.
Now, if you are going to sing with him, I leave. Miss Kirsten, auf Wiedersehen. And to you, gentlemen, Achtung!
He missed it. Well, Miss Kirsten, can we hear a song from you?
I'd be delighted. Let's see, what shall it be? Caro nome, non più andrai, un bel dì vedremo.
Please, Miss Kirsten, watch your language. The place will get raided.
Jerry, that's Italian. Oh, Signorina Kirsten.
Sì, Signor Martino.
Well, doggone. Ladies and gentlemen, the lovely voice of Miss Dorothy Kirsten.
Jerry, don't compare your voice with Dorothy's. After all, she's an opera star.
Opera? Who understands opera? It's all sung in Italian.
Hey, what do you mean? What's so bad about singing in Italian?
Oh, pardon me, Ezio.
Well, Jerry, some operas just happen to be written in Italian.
Yeah, I know. But if I wrote an opera, I'd do it in English. And I'd have a very simple story. Maybe something about our nightclub.
Hey, that's a good idea. It'll be just like Carmen.
The opera Lombardo.
I bet that's very funny at the Metropolitan. Listen. Here's the way our opera might go.
Ladies and gentlemen, this afternoon, the National Broadcasting Company is proud to present an opera by Jerry Lewis. This new American composition is entitled Il Trovatore Goes to a Nightclub, or How to Get Huckled for a Buck. Dean Martin plays the part of Jerry Lewis. Jerry Lewis plays the part of Dean Martin. Neither man felt equipped to play the part of Dorothy Kirsten. The scene opens in a restaurant with Dean and Jerry as singing waiters.
Dean, don't worry about dinner. I've got the spaghetti and meatballs ready to cook. You should have. You've been working on the spaghetti for 3 whole days. Yes, but it's all your fault that it took so long. You made me go through each piece of spaghetti with a pipe cleaner.
Now the front door of the club opens, and in sweeps the beautiful Miss Kirsten. She sits down at a table. She should have waited for a chair.
Oh, I'm the Princess Ria Rita. I'm traveling incognita. Fate does play such horrible quirks. My life's in the hands of these two jerks.
Here's the menu. And now, miss, what else would you like to have?
I'd like some of that over there.
Where?
There.
There?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, madam, but that's my partner, Dean.
Fair maid, it is I, Dino Martini, at your service.
Kiss me again.
Jerry, I didn't mean you.
How did I know? This is the first time I've ever been in an opera.
And so the two lovers sing a love song together while Jerry sadly watches from a corner table. Little does Miss Kirsten, really Princess Ria Rita, know that Jerry is actually the Prince Romanoff, heir to the Romanoff diamonds in the Beverly Hills restaurant.
Dino, my dearest, do you love me?
Oh, yes, fair maid. I would lay down my partner's life for you.
Oh, Dino, I'm so glad. And now I have a confession to make, a true confession.
Don't tell him. I'll get you to Sam Goldwyn and we'll film it.
But before she can confess, the door of the nightclub flies open and a sinister-looking man says,
"Don't move anybody. I've got you all covered with this gun. I'm not going to waste any time with you."
"What's the matter with you?"
"I'm parked in a 5-minute zone.
Watch out for him. He's dangerous. He's my husband.
He's your husband?
Yes, he's my husband, and I'm his wife.
Yes, she is my wife, and I am her husband.
You two are married?
Explain. We were married when I was 3 years old. Then he left me for a younger woman.
Well, then fear him not. We will protect you. Jerry, lad, if bullets begin to fly, do your duty. Get in front of me.
Oh, where can I hide? Where can I hide?
Shame I didn't go through the spaghetti with a bigger pipe cleaner.
Princess, this gun is pointing at you.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. Is das nicht ein Gun that shoots?
Ja, das ist ein Gun that shoots.
Ha! And so is this ein Gun that shoots.
You got me! You got me too!
I'm dying.
And I'm dying too.
You go ahead. Die first. Be my guest.
Well, Miss Kirsten, that's the first act. Do you think we could be an opera?
Yeah, Miss Kirsten, do you think we might get with the Metropolitan?
Frankly, I don't think you could get with Prudential.
Well, Dorothy, it's a cinch. I can't do opera with you, but how about singing a popular tune with me?
Good, Dean. I think we'll be on much safer ground.
Let's take an old-fashioned walk. I'm just bursting with power. What a tale could be told if we went for an old-fashioned walk.
Let's take a stroll through the park, down a lane where it's dark, and the heart that's controlled may relax on an old-fashioned walk. Miles apart.
There's nothing like walking and having a heart to heart.
I know a girl who declined, couldn't make up her mind.
She was wrapped up in soul,
coming home from an old-fashioned walk. Some couples go for a buggy ride when they start caring a lot. Others will bicycle side by side
out to some romantic spot.
But when you haven't a suit,
there's only one thing to do.
Let's take an old-fashioned walk.
I'm just bursting with talk. What a tale could be told
if we went on an old-fashioned walk.
Let's take a stroll through the park.
Down a lane where it's dark.
And a heart that's controlled
may relax on an old-fashioned walk.
There's nothing like walking and having a heart to heart.
Walking and talking and
I know a girl who declined, couldn't make up her mind. She was wrapped up in soul,
coming home from an old-fashioned walk.
If your girl has declined
and won't make up her mind,
what you need is a heart-to-heart talk.
Take a stroll through the park,
down a lane where it's dark, and go.
Thank you, Miss Dorothy Kirsten, and good night, everyone.
See you all next week. Good night, folks. Bye.
The Martin Lewis Show, transcribed in Hollywood, is produced by Robert L. Redd, written by Charlie Isaacs, Jack Douglas, Dick McKnight, and Ray Allen. Next week, our guest will be George Jessel. Dorothy Kirsten appears with the courtesy of Lucky Strike's Light Up Time. Martin and Lewis currently may be seen in person at the New York Paramount Theater in conjunction with their picture, My Friend Irma. This is Ben Alexander suggesting you tune in to your NBC station next week, this same hour, for the Martin and Lewis Show.
Coming up now is William Bendix living the life of Riley on NBC.